So to reiterate just once more, using the key.prototype here instead of the key.methods is purely cosmetic. Don't get confused thinking about the possible effects that this might have on the in-memory model at runtime, since there really aren't any. Here's some examples of associations you might be making in your mind that would mislead you. First of all, the car function does not delegate its failed lookups to the object stored at car.prototype. There is no such thing as car.move, for example. We never imagined that car would delegate its failed lookups to car.methods, and so we shouldn't expect that car would delegate its failed lookups to car.prototype. Another point is that result objects from the car function only delegate to car.prototype because of our own call to this object.create function. It's not because we're using the key.prototype to store this object that we have a relationship between instances and the car.prototype object. So you should really see this .prototype object as a freely provided object for storing things, with no additional special characteristics. Mentally, you can substitute the word .methods if it helps you reason about it. To underscore my point, observe that this example function has the exact same relationship with the car.prototype object that the car function does. Both functions return objects that are set up to delegate to the object stored at car.prototype. The fact that the prototype object is stored as a property of only one of those two functions is completely immaterial. Both functions behave exactly the same as they would if that prototype object had been merely stored in some global variable.